Hi guys, Brett here from Seed Terminator. While we've got this mill apart and open so we've got access to it, I'm going to give you a quick run through on how to actually measure and determine wear and get an estimate of the life remaining in your screens, rotors and flails. The only special tool that you're going to need is going to be a vernier. So what we'll do first is talk about the screen. So the mill screen we can inspect with it in situ. And what we're doing is we're looking at the upright bars and we're going to take a measurement with our vernier in and around the upright bar. So we pull our vernier away from the screen so that we pick up the angle that it's wearing at on the inside. And if you put your finger in there, you can actually feel it. And we find that measurement and we go and have a look on our vernier. They start off at 9.6 to 10 mil, depending on the laser cut. And so call it 10 mil. At 5 mil, they're 50% worn. This one is 8.5 mil. So we've lost a mil of its 10 mil. So this screen is completely reusable. So what I'm going to do now, I'm very quickly going to whip out the 5 retaining bolts and lift the screen out. And then we're going to have a look at the rotor. Now, because the screen sits on 5 index bolts, you may not be able to just grab it and lift it out. So using a pry bar or a tire lever or some other device, you may just release the screen from the retainers and lift it off. So once it's off, sit it on top, get a good grip on it and pivot it out of the way. So once we've got our screen off, we can actually look on the inside and we can actually see the amount of wear that it has. And we can see that there is a little bit more wear just at the very, very bottom of the screen. So now that we've removed our screen and it's out of the way, we can actually get clear access to our rotor and our flails. So we can actually measure for wear. So our rotor bars are aerodynamically designed and hard-faced. And if we have a look, there will be a little tiny, in this one, there's a little tiny bit of wear. You can see there's a higher and lower wear point right on the very leading corner of the rotor bar. And we try and find the most worn part of the rotor. We can actually see the scalloping along the edge of the bar. The rotor bar is going to wear more on the outside than the inside, same as the screen, which we'll wear on the outside as well. So to measure our rotor bar for wear, if we actually measure the rotor bar thickness from brand new, it should be 19 millimeters. Okay. And then what we need to do is find the worst worn piece of the bar and measure to find out how much material is missing. And in this particular rotor bar, I'm not going to be able to measure because 99% of it is still there. So this rotor has done a whole season and is hardly showing any signs of wear. So the last thing that we're going to look at when we're doing our mill inspection is our flail, okay? So where the flail is going to wear on the outside of the tooth's corner, and it is going to wear along the top of the rebate, okay? So we see we've got a machined rebate in here which lightens the flail, and it will wear along the top edge of that rebate, okay? This we can see the sharp corner is rolled off on both the inside and the outside, and there's a little tiny bit of rolling to the outer edge of the flail, okay? These flails look almost new, but again, these have done a whole season. What you are going to see on a badly worn flail, this area at the top of the flail is going to thin and become razor sharp. This area along here will become razor sharp and roll at the top, and it will start to undercut where it meets the base of the flail. this round corner is going to wear away from the top, working its way down, and it will be very round instead of nice and sharp. And it may wear so thin that it starts to crack through this corner. That is the point at which you need to replace your flails. Once we've inspected our mill and we know pretty much that it's going to last our next season, we then go and put it back together. Simple matter of lifting our screen back into position, torquing down our five fasteners, and then reassemble all of our guarding and shooting and covers.